Hello, fellow humans. So if you guys have a Cyro or a Cyborg from Azeron, maybe you've questioned if it was possible to get a magnetic Hall effect analog stick instead of the normal potentiometers. And that's what this video is about. So I'll just go right ahead and start to take care of this. So you'll need to, first of all, disassemble this bit so that you can release the analog module. So just, you don't really have to pull this all off. So once you get this, you probably want to unplug this here so you can put your Cyro aside and just work with the module itself. So you'll need to remove two bottom screws here. And once you do this, this is the board. It's also secured by another screw here. So this one goes out. And you keep it aside, don't lose it. So you'll need probably to remove the cap. And if you wiggle it a bit, and you can pull it off. And I might as well just pull the cap off too. So these Azeron ones, potentiometers come with two caps. Actually, I've already done this because what I'm showing you, I already tried it. So I know it, so I knew that it was possible. So I'm just doing this tutorial. So first thing you will need to do will be to actually remove this potentiometer, and this is a this is the most tricky part of all of this, and I already done it, and I won't do it here. So, but for you guys that are actually doing this, first thing you'll need to do is remove these two caps here. So just grab your iron. And I just have them secured by one spot because this is all prepared for this already. You guys will have a bit more trouble doing this because yours will be actually secured and everything will be soldered. So after removing these two caps, you'll have to remove all these solders, and well, there are several techniques to do this. I won't do it here again because I already did it, but well, you should remember to use flux, use low melt solder, and try to clean all the solder off. And if you have a heat gun, maybe try with a heat gun. I actually did mine with a heat gun, but be careful to protect the wires here because they will melt all the isolation. So well, I already pulled this off, so I'm just going to take it off. And what you need now is one of these. I bought actually several ones, and I have some to show you the difference. So no matter what model you buy, the actual magnet part, so this part here, will be the same if this is using a black part or a yellow part. But for the Cyro or the Cyborg, you will want to use one with two orange parts, okay? So the black ones won't work. The black ones, there's a chip inside these. Let me just pull one off. I'll just pull in a bit. There's the chip inside these, and if this is connected to the Cyro board with a black sensor, it will just short the boards, and the Cyro, and probably the Cyborg also, won't even turn on. So let's get to it. You'll need one of these. These are the ones that are suited for the PS5 controllers, and you can buy them in lots of places at AliExpress, probably other stores too. I bought mine on AliExpress. So if you put the if you solder these directly on the boards, the horizontal axis will be reversed. So it means when you go left, the cursor will actually go the opposite way. So left goes right, right goes left, so yeah. So to go around this, you'll need to do this. You just use something sharp here and try to pry it here where there's a little tab and go like this and just on one side and it goes right off. So this is the chip, okay? So these are polarities. One is the voltage one, the other one is the ground one. So if you use the black ones again, it will short and it will not work with your Cyro or your Azeron. So once you have these open, this is what you'll find. So this is the small part here, the part with the magnet. And this is the chip that detects the magnetic field here. So because I tried this, so this is the comparison. What you'll need to do is to go from here to here. Okay, so this is just a matter of turning this piece around, which I will do now. I actually like to do this with a small flathead here also. So I'm using the Cyro one. This came with the Cyro. It's a really cool tool. So use something sharp here, flat, and just put it under here and lift it up. Once you got it like this, you will need to separate this middle part here. So just turn it around, use something to put it in and push it, and it will separate. So now just grab it, and as you can see, there's a smaller part and a larger part. So the smaller part is the one that goes in. So again, you want to turn this around so magnet was facing up. So you'll have to turn it, turn this one too, and push it back in. So this is the end result. So just grab it, put it back on. Just don't put it all the way in, because it may cause some friction, additional friction, and we don't want that. So once it's like this, you just put the sensor back on and you can resolder this back. So you grab the board, and I'll do this part now. Just align the holes. So this goes on the part that has this writing here. Push it in. And time to solder all the things back in place. Apply some flux. Actually, for this, I will only be using, I will only be soldering the three pins for the actual sensors, because I will try to do some modifications later. So it doesn't make it even harder to remove afterwards. Okay, this is good enough. Just gonna clean this. And if you're doing this, you will probably want to solder back the caps. So if you were doing this, you would probably want to get these two caps back, so they go on the bottom. This goes here and this goes here, so you just had to solder these back on. But for this tutorial, I won't do it because it's not needed. I'm just doing it to show it. So, and these are actually not really, really needed. I was told this was used for some protection from LEDs. I don't even know exactly what it means, but well, Azeron put it in. It must do something. And actually, I won't even assemble this. I will keep this like this, so that you guys can see it working on my computer. So here's the Cyro, it's connected to the computer using the Hall Effect stick. You probably should calibrate it, but luck or not, mine just came out perfectly calibrated. You just, no drift at all. In the meantime, I spoke to Azeron support, and they told me that one of these boards would cost around 50 cents plus VAT plus shipping. So for any of you having trouble desoldering this, maybe it's easier just to contact Azeron and ask them for a board, which is really cheap and saves you a lot of trouble. Thank you.